Cradled in the lap of the majestic Himalayas, Kashmir is aptly called paradise on earth. From dazzling white snow of winters to blooming fragrance of spring, nature is at its pristine best here. Astounding varieties of flora further enhance the valley's exotic beauty. Among these, saffron is the most coveted treasure of the land. Besides Spain, Iran, and Afghanistan, Kashmir is the only place in the world where best quality saffron has existed since ages. It has been grown mostly in the field of Pampore town, located 11 kilometers away from Srinagar. The purple flowers blooming first above the ground hold the essence of this wonderful spice, which is the most expensive one in the world. Kesari color stigmas of the flowers are used as saffron or kesar to impart pleasant aroma and awesome orange color to the various recipes. Besides, saffron is also used in many industries, including the pharmaceutical industry. The market price of saffron ranges from 1.5 to 3 lakh rupees per kilogram, depending upon the quality and trade scenario. But the crux lies in the fact that 100 kilograms of fresh flowers yield only about 3 kilograms of dried stigmas called saffron. Not long ago, the scenario was not as promising as it appears today. Due to continuous decline in production, productivity and quality, farmers were considering relinquishing cultivation of saffron in Kashmir. The area under saffron was shrinking at a pace that experts feared extinction in the near future. Farmers were practicing traditional cropping methods, which included to address these issues, National Agricultural Innovation Project, NAIP, working under the umbrella of the Indian Council of Agricultural Research, launched a special initiative in the year 2009. The mission-oriented project, A Value Chain on Kashmir Saffron, was initiated in collaboration with Sher-e Kashmir University of Agricultural Sciences and Technology, Srinagar. The story of transformation started unfolding. On top of the list of immediate tasks was development of appropriate technologies. Corn, being the key to success, got first attention. Standards were developed to grade corms as per quality. This resulted in prevention of corm rot disease to a large extent, which was previously a major barrier to the yield. Integrated nutrient management was another important module to enhance yield and quality. Use of vermicompost proved instrumental in improving soil health. An effective module for rodent management was also developed to prevent damage to corms. Irrigation schedules, both at pre- and post-flowering stages, saved crop from moisture stress. To maintain the quality, scientists suggested 2-day-old flowers should be picked up only during morning hours and stigmas should be separated within 4 to 5 hours of picking. An improved methodology for picking of flowers and separation of stigmas was also devised to improve quality. Drying of flowers is crucial to get higher yield. Hence, in place of traditional sun drying, the use of solar or electrical hot air dryers was recommended. Improved technologies, procedures and recommendations were ready, but to motivate farmers for adoption was a daunting task. The farmers were skeptical about its effectiveness and success. However, the project team succeeded initially in motivating at least 275 farmers to adopt these latest technologies. And since this first step, there is no looking back. Popularity of NAIP technologies among farmers is increasing day by day. This because farmers are witnessing the quantum jump in productivity.
2009 में NAIP ने हमें एक नया तरीका बता दिया है। उससे हमारा बहुत फायदा हुआ है। पहले हमारे जो एक हेक्टर है उसमें दो या ढाई किलो वो जाफरान आता है। लेकिन आज हमें उसकी नस्बत बहुत उसमें फायदा आ गया। अब ये उसी NAIP की बदौलत से हमें ये फायदा मिला है।
2009 में NAIP आया था। NAIP ने हमें बहुत कुछ दिया है। इसमें हमें नर्सरी का कंसेप्ट मिला। नर्सरी से हमें ये फायदा मिला कि प्रोडक्शन है, हमें इससे प्रोडक्शन बढ़ गया। पहले हम इसी तरह धूप में सुखाया, छाव में सुखाया, कमरों में सुखाया करते थे, मगर अब हमें हॉट ड्रायर मिले हैं, हमें सोलर ड्रायर मिले हैं। इसे हम खाली 3 घंटों में इसको सुखाते, इससे हमें ये फायदा मिलता है कि इसका रंग बहुत अच्छा रहता है। पहले हम हेक्टर में निकालते थे, इससे पहले 2 केजी, अब हमारा जो प्रोडक्शन बढ़ गया वो कम से 12 केजी तक हो गया।
कीपिंग इन व्यू द हाई प्राइस, द हाइक इन प्रोडक्टिविटी इज इनॉर्मस। Scientific cultivation of saffron is picking up fast in the valley. Nearly half of the total cultivated area of saffron is now under NAIP technologies, and the entire area is expected to be covered by 2014. The NAIP project also helped and facilitated creation of appropriate infrastructure for post-harvest processing. With the intervention of the project, a cooperative venture has been established for modern packing of the product. Market linkage is proving beneficial for growers in terms of monetary returns. High quality saffron is opening up new markets in India and abroad as well.
पहले हमारी पोस्ट हार्वेस्टिंग जो लॉस हो रही थी वो 30% थी, लेकिन NAIP के माध्यम से हमें फ़ायदा मिला, ये 30% हमारे अब बच रहे हैं। NAIP की गाइडलाइन से जो हमें फ़ायदा मिला है उसमें हमने ये जो पिकिंग, सेपरेशन, ड्राइंग और पैकिंग अभी स्टार्ट किए हैं। ये हमारी जा रही है अभी बम्बई, हैदराबाद, दिल्ली, राजस्थान, पूरे क्षेत्रों में जा रही है अभी। और रिसेंटली हमें NAIP की ही माध्यम से एक बायर मिला है जो फ्रांस का है, और हम एक्सपोर्ट कर रहे हैं। हम बहुत खुश हैं इस NAIP प्रोग्राम से, हम बहुत खुश हैं।
Farmers generally used to throw away waste petals of saffron flower, but not anymore. NAIP project, a value chain on enhanced productivity and profitability of Pashmina fiber, has successfully standardized the technology for using waste petals of saffron flowers in preparation of an organic dye. This will minimize post-harvest waste, opening up another potential revenue stream for saffron farmers.
We established 5 technologies that have improved the productivity level from 2.5 to 8 to 10 kgs per hectare. We have developed the post-harvest technologies that helps us to avoid the post-harvest losses that were to the extent of 30% by traditional practices. Now under the NAIP, we have established a post-harvest unit that is taking care of all the post-harvest technologies that have been established in the NAIP. And thirdly, we have established the 3 societies that have been developed under the NAIP to link them directly with the traders as well as the exporters to avoid the role of the middlemen. Then, so far as the capacity building is concerned, till date 4,000 saffron growers of Jammu and Kashmir have been trained by giving them practical training as well as by demonstrating them through farmers' participatory research approach.
The world-renowned saffron belt is basking under the winds of change. The saffron revolution has already set in. Thanks to NAIP, the aroma and color of saffron is lighting up the lives of thousands of growers.